have helped shape American history. And today, at the National World War II Museum in New Orleans, the Greatest Generation is swapping stories with the next generation, giving students a living lesson on the war. Instead of a call to arms, it's been dubbed a call to ears. Robert Wolf volunteers at the museum, sharing his experiences with the Army's 343rd Infantry Regiment. And Stephen Suazo is a sixth grader at Patrick Taylor Academy, one of dozens of students taking it all in today. And it looks like a very great turnout there. So, Robert, give me an idea, you know, what kinds of stories, how detailed you're getting with a lot of these young people about your experiences.
Well, mostly we're making a valiant effort to try to help them imagine what it was like to be, to live at that time. It was a quite different time, and it was one of those situations where everybody in the country was involved, and it's a real effort of imagination to begin to think that one is participating in it. Now, Stefan here is one of our best customers at the museum. He's been here a number of times, and it's a pleasure to talk with him because he is interested in almost everything. I was talking to him before we went on about the Higgins boat. We're sitting in front of a Higgins boat, an LCVP, and talking to him about what the contribution was of Mr. Higgins and Higgins Industries in New Orleans. Of
wow.
course, that's one of the reasons that this museum is in New Orleans.
And it really is a beautiful museum. And Mr.
Yes.
Wolf, we were looking at some pictures of you. You were 18 years old when you served. And so I wonder, you know, Stefan, when you hear, you know, firsthand account from Mr. Wolf about his experience in the war, what most surprises you about what it was to serve in World War II?
Well, to me, what surprises me is how much effort they really had to put to defeat these people. I mean, it's amazing. It's no wonder that we have a Veterans Day. And I mean, with all the valor, bravery, and loyalty they showed during this war, it's obvious that they deserved it.
And so, Stefan, had you ever heard of these first-person account stories before meeting Mr. Wolf?
Yes, I have spoken to many veterans during my time at this museum. There's almost every day there's veterans here, so I take every opportunity I can get to speak to them.
And Mr. Wolf, how important is it, in your view, that so many young people are coming out, not just today, but on a regular basis, school children will come in and the likes of you and other vets are there to enhance the displays that are there at the World War II Museum with your first-person accounts?
Well, that's one of the more important things in the museum. But it's not only the school children who come in. Increasingly, we're getting adult children and adult grandchildren, veterans who come in. And they are, in some ways, even more interested in the stories that we have to tell than the school children are. And it's very gratifying to be able to give them some sense of what it was like to live in those times. You know, I'm generally taken aback when people want to thank me for my service because I didn't volunteer for anything. I did what everybody did at the time and what I'm sure that everybody would do if called upon to do it again.
Well, then maybe we need to rephrase it and say that we're grateful for your service because I think every American feels that way. Very grateful for your service and your dedication. Mr. Robert Wolf and Stefan Suazo, thanks so much for your time and enjoy the day and pass on the word to your fellow vets there that we are all very grateful for what you have done.
Thank you.
No problem. Thanks.
So for ways that you can honor our troops this Veterans Day and throughout the year, visit our Impact Your World page. That's cnn.com/impact.
Back in the 80s, it was really tough for me and my family.